For the first time since March 13th, 163 days ago, kids will begin in-person learning in School District 2 buildings tomorrow. How long that will last was the question county health officials attempted to answer this morning at a press conference at Riverstone Health that also included SD2 Superintendent Greg Upham. Q2's Mitch Lagge has more on new COVID benchmarks officials will be watching closely.
As it stands Sunday, half of Montana's 1,500 active COVID-19 patients are from Yellowstone County, and the health department recorded a 12% jump in new cases per day over the course of last week. A majority of Billings students will head back to the classroom on Monday amid the increase in case counts.
And what I want to communicate to our parents and our teachers, our staff, is that we need to be flexible. Are we approaching numbers that could place us into remote? Possibly. I want us to be ready to change at a moment's notice and move to the direction we need to move when we need to move.
Yellowstone County Health Officer John Felton shared four criteria that will be analyzed to make future decisions about schools. They have all been assigned a status from green to yellow and red. The first two measures require interpretation from doctors. The last two are purely data-driven. Officials will monitor the nature of new cases, including where they originate and the ages of those infected, keeping a particular eye on schools. Next is the status and capacity of the local hospitals and the health department to ensure there's enough help for contact tracing. And for data-driven points, officials will watch the 7-day average of new cases per 100,000 people. As well, the weekly positivity rate, calculated by the State Department of Public Health and Human Services.
The clinical metrics we developed are designed to help us understand if things are getting better or if the direction is getting worse in our community, and how much of that direction is being affected by the schools being open.
As of Sunday, all metrics have the status of yellow. It would take three of the four being in the red status for the health department to issue a recommendation to close county schools. Officials are looking at the entire picture of COVID-19 in the community and won't make decisions based off of only one of the metrics.
When we look at trends, we're able to see if we're heading in the right direction or if we're heading in the wrong direction. And we want to be able to make the changes that we need to make before we've hit major critical thresholds.
Students in Billings School District 2 will head back to in-person classes starting on Monday. But Yellowstone County Health Officer John Felton reiterated that it's up to all of us in the community to make sure that schools remain open. In Billings, Mitch Lagge, MTN News.
Thank you, Mitch. Upham also released a new block schedule for the three Billings high schools this morning. Previously, the high schoolers were going to operate the same way as the middle schools, going to periods 1, 2, and 3 one day, then switching to 4, 5, and 6 the next day, and so on. Now, students will change classes weekly, periods 1, 2, and 3 for 5 days, then 4, 5, and 6 for the next 5 to reduce the number of interactions with teachers in classrooms. Middle and elementary schools will keep their previously agreed schedules for now.